Well, the people who don't have food allergies are out there being literal sociopaths again, so I have to inflict my opinions upon all of you once again. There's an entire corner of YouTube that's literally just people who don't have food allergies throwing tantrums. Absolute piss baby toddler tantrums over the fact that there exist in the world foods that they wouldn't eat, and people who eat things they wouldn't eat, and especially people who don't eat things that they would eat. And I just want to remind you all that some people have real problems. Let me tell you a story. Once upon a time, and by once upon a time, I mean yesterday, I was working at my new job and I drank something that had incredibly minor amounts of corn in it. And I had a seizure, fainted twice, threw up, and hit my head on the floor such that it was bleeding and I have a bump. Do you know why that happened? Because I'm allergic to corn, okay? I don't know if you know this, but sometimes people are allergic to things. And so, what it means when they're allergic to things is, I don't know if you know this, they can't have it. And if they do have it, it's bad. And so, if you say, "Hey, would you like this thing?" they'll say, "No, it will make me sick and or kill me." And that's when the able-bodied person throws a piss baby toddler tantrum. A lot of times, what will happen if you tell somebody you're allergic to something is they'll file that away, and then the next time they have the opportunity, they'll make something for you to eat that has that thing in it, but they'll lie to you and tell you that it doesn't because they want to prove to you that your allergy isn't real. Able-bodied people will literally try to kill us, genuinely, medically murder us, to prove to us that they know more about our allergies than we do. I cannot tell you how many times this has been done to me. And yet, there are grown-ass men who make a livelihood on YouTube by screeching about how there are people who don't eat the foods that they think that they should. You want me to die. You literally want me to die. Because you can't handle the thought of somebody else eating differently from you. Even people who haven't literally tried to kill me have gone to great lengths to remind me that they think that the things that I eat are disgusting or weird. When considering the choice between me dying or me eating something that's weird to them, they think it's better for me to die. So, I just want to give you a rule of thumb. If anybody ever says that any diet is healthy for everyone or unhealthy for everyone, they're wrong. Do you know why? Because food allergies exist. You have two separate immune systems, so you have two different types of allergies, and both of those immune systems are completely individualized. There is no food that's universally safe. There are things that are universally unsafe, but that's because they're like not food, you know? There's no diet that's safe for everyone. There's no dietary advice that's safe for everyone. And I want to be clear. For every diet that comes along, there are going to be people who are grifters or who don't understand it and spread misinformation. Like, is there a lot of nonsense about keto and paleo diets? Yeah, there is. That doesn't mean they're a scam. Is oat milk, in the end, equally environmentally harmful as cow's milk? Probably, but you're not throwing a tantrum about people drinking cow's milk because it's environmentally harmful. You're throwing a tantrum about people drinking oat milk because you don't think it's normal. And you're pretending that it's about the environment when it's really about hating people with food allergies. Because it's always open season on people with food allergies. There is no type of illness that is more universally disrespected than food allergies. I'm not saying it doesn't happen, but the people I know who have diabetes don't seem to be talking about how everyone they know constantly jokes about how they would love to kill them via their illness. They might joke about how easy it would be for a person with diabetes to die, but they wouldn't typically joke about actually killing someone via manipulating their access to insulin. Again, like I literally made a video about how I won't work as a cook anymore because of this. Every chronically well person makes a joke about how it would be funny to murder people with food allergies. This is why I don't have relationships. This is why I don't talk to people. This is why I don't want to get to know chronically well people ever. Because they're just dead inside. They don't see us as human. And when giant corporations, after years of us begging, condescend to make a couple products that we can eat without getting sick, chronically well people just lose their goddamn shit. It's the worst thing that's ever happened to them that people can buy ice cream made from oats. It's just the worst thing that's ever happened to these people that somebody's out there eating paleo. Do you remember the story I told you earlier in the video about how I drank a little bit of corn syrup and I had a seizure, passed out twice, threw up, and hit my head? Some people have real problems. I don't know if you know that. I literally face death every single moment of every single day. And to be honest, I face it the most because of the choices of able-bodied people, not because of my actual illness. So every single day, able-bodied people go out into the world and contaminate it with all of these allergens that they bring in there. They make us sick. They make it impossible for us to be safe in the world. They shame us for staying home when they make the world unsafe by bringing allergens into it. They shame us for eating the food that doesn't make us sick. And they joke about how much they wish they could murder us. And then they go on YouTube and make videos about how special diets or allergy-friendly products are a scam. If you have mast cell activation syndrome, and I want to be clear, if you're neurodivergent, you have mast cell activation syndrome. So if you're neurodivergent, then a dietitian is probably the most likely to kill you, okay? You do not want to listen to any dietitian unless that dietitian has specifically been trained for dealing with patients with mast cell activation syndrome. Everything that regular dietitians are taught is fatal, potentially, to neurodivergent people because they literally don't understand that you have two separate immune systems. Dietitians are not the experts on anything except for how to kill and torture neurodivergent people. If somebody says, "My mom's a dietitian, so I know everything," like, you need to get as far away from that person as possible because that person will try to kill you to prove to you that you're wrong. That's what living with food allergies is like. Everybody constantly tries to kill you to prove to you that you're wrong. And when they can't do that, they just go on YouTube and make videos about how much they hate it that you're allowed to eat anything at all. How much they hate it that you're out there not eating the diet they want you to eat. Again, some people have real problems.